Okay, it's June 11th, 2018. It's Monday. See, this is what I'm talking about. That's four zucchini right here. Green on the right. One here and one in the back. Yellow. You see how full these things are? That's up to my waist right there. You can see the flowers in there. I sprinkled some domesius earth on there yesterday. Down inside there. See, you can see a couple of yellow zucchinis in there. We've had one of each off here yesterday. We ate fresh zucchini off the vine, or off the plant, I guess you'd say. This is the okra, green okra. I'm not sure if this is spineless okra or not, because we had seeds for spineless okra that I put out here. Wind is going to cut off my mic, so I got my hand over the mic. And then we got one, two, technically, in the corner. So say two, three, four, five, six, red okra. And then that's basil down there. I think it's just one basil plant. My wife had a bunch of them down there. We planted them around in the back of the number three garden. This is the number one garden, by the way. A little baby frog. See a little toad? He hopped up, he's underneath there. And we got toads out here like crazy. There's a pool before. See, I don't know what happened here. If you look at this, let me get out of the garden in the middle here. See, this is a bad location where I have this grass. It's hard to mow it. But see how that is like broke apart? I don't understand. I gotta get some. See, now you see that spot on this leaves? I don't know if it's coming out on there with this design, which I really don't like. It looks like white powdery, mildewy stuff, mildewy looking. Get some baking soda, a tablespoon of baking soda, to a quart bottle, of spray bottle, and mix it up and spray it on your leaves. That helps get the fungus off. Plus, I put a penny in the ground because copper is supposed to help the plants. I put a penny in these two. I couldn't get to the center of these because those are so big and full. But I put a copper penny in that one and in that one in the ground. This is cantaloupe. Look how this stuff is exploding. Let me zoom out a little bit. And this one. Now this is a bunch of watermelon too. Oh look, you can see one right there even. I can't see it on this viewfinder, of course, because you know the design is made that way. There's one right in the middle there. You can see it. Otherwise, the whole north, let's see, this would be the southwest corner of the number three garden. Is all watermelon. And this is a different type of watermelon, although it looks more like a cantaloupe, but it should be a different type of watermelon. And then cantaloupe as you go further that way. And cucumbers. Cucumbers have the pointed looking leaves. Hey, look at the watermelon now. I don't know if I can see them over here with the sun to my back. The sun is behind me, it's east. That's west. You can see the flowers in there. There's flowers right here. You can see the little bees going in there? They're not honeybees per se, but they're little tiny bees and all that. They're pollinating them. You can see all the, see the little watermelon right there. There's three or four inside here we saw yesterday about size of bigger, just bigger than softballs. But it's different types of watermelon. It's the long, elongated type, which is wilt ham, and then there's sugar baby, which are the round ones. Sugar baby, which is the round one, like a basketball. Last year, the year before last, we had one, it was 20 pounds. See, I can't really see them now with all these leaves. That's what the leaves are for, too, is to protect them. But see, this is the smaller two that are coming out. One's about the size of a billiard ball right there somewhere, and then there's a little tiny one, smaller than a golf ball. It's about the size of a big marble. But anyway, that's that. And then in the back here, see there's a basil. We got two eggplants. This is an eggplant right down there. In the corner there is an eggplant. And again, I'm not going to be zooming in and out because this is a Sony. It's a piece of junk. $300 piece of crap. Runs through AA batteries like crazy. See, that's basil. Going east now. See, I was going to put peppers back here as they come up. Peppers are real slow this year. I think that's basil. Let me see if I can see it on there. Looks like insects were getting at, but insects usually stay away from basil. That's a pepper down there. The pepper down there. Pepper in that back. Whoa, see, I'm losing my balance here. Pepper right down there. And pepper right down there. The tomatoes. Oh, here's another one. This one was from last year. It just started coming up with them. This looks like it's a cantaloupe or a honeydew, whichever. Right up there too. See, sometimes these seeds fall off. Don't know. Anyway, we're not taking this plastic up like we did this year to till underneath here and put fertilizer. We're just gonna leave it like it is this year. Next year we'll plant different stuff, different areas. But this is just 50, 56 approximately. Let's just say 60 feet from east to west, and 30 feet to 34 feet from north to south. This is the south end. That's the east end. That's north end. So let's say 60 feet from east to west and 34 feet from south to north. Okay. Now the tomatoes. These things were, they had drift on them from the Monsanto corn food-like product out in the garden, out in the yard, out in the field out here. 360 acres of food-like product around us. That's about 25 feet away from the garden right there, 30 feet away from the garden. But when they sprayed their crap over there and killed off the grass, the drift got over here, and there were like yellow spots all over these leaves, and stupid me didn't get out here until 2 days later, and I washed it all off. And they're coming back, so they're okay with that. Generally, these are heirloom. They wouldn't be so resilient and come back from toxic shit from Monsanto. See, this one doesn't look so healthy. Look how the leaves are kind of curled. Not giving it any more water or anything like that. But anyway, see all that right in front? It's the stuff they sprayed that killed it off. It's all brown down there. And that drift came over here. It killed off 60% of the sunflowers I had up and down here. This is the north wall or the north fence I had. Killed off 60% of that. And then you see dead leaves on some of the others. Over there, everything on the northwest corner died off. I've got others coming back. I've transplanted a bunch of them over here. That's why a lot of these are transplanted. And as you go further back south, they're healthier. So Monsanto was poison, folks. You want to keep eating that? That's why 80% of Europe will not import our vegetables. They will not eat our meat because of the growth crap they put in the food for the cattle to eat. So you are what you eat. This is not the best, but it's better than the crap in the store. I'll tell you that much right now. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 good sized tomato plants right now. 7 if you want to count that one. It's about 18 inches high over there. So 7. Then we have 8. Well, this one, if it'll come back, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. This one I accidentally broke. You can even see the top of it. I actually broke it with my hand. Snipping off of the bad leaves. 15, 16, that one too looks somewhat diseased, some of the leaves on there. 16 and 17, 18, I lost track again. 17 or 18 plants out here. See, I'm gonna consider this as a big one, okay? It's even had a flower on there. I can see the flower at the top, right there. 1, 2, 3, 4 in the back, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 big ones. We'll be getting tomatoes off these in about 2 more weeks, if not sooner. Other people say they've already got tomatoes coming off of their plants. A lot of them also bought them from China Mart and bought plants. These are all from seed. Everything out here is from seed, from Heirloom Solutions. See, I take this, I pinch it with my finger, my thumbnail usually, and get the leaf off. But see, on that one, like I said, I'm right there, I pinched it and then I jerked it down and I tore it right in half. But it's coming back now, as you can see, but it's got some leaves that look not too good. Tomato plants, usually I should dispose of it. You're supposed to burn them and get it away from the plant. They're susceptible to a lot of things. This is here, this plant right here is about 48 inches high. So that's 48 inches high. That's probably about 36 inches. That's about 30 inches. Okay, and then the beans over here, they're not doing as good as I was hoping, but again, as I say in all my videos, this is a learning process. I am by no stretch of anybody's imagination a farmer. I've been doing this for about 8 years, roughly, 7 years. Different, having to move to different places and getting a place where we can have a garden. That one's doing okay. I got strings going up to my mom's swing frame here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 bean strands going to it. But right now, these are coming up. That's a black eyed pea. Should be 2 of them in there. There's a sweet pea in the corner. Don't remember, which is a bad thing right there. Then there's a bean here, which I'm not, I've had it all written down before. These three are purple hull peas. That one, and that one right there. And there's sweet pea in that corner. There's 2 or 3 growing right there. And there's black eyed peas right here. And I had put sweet pea in the corner there, but it's not growing. And then we have 144 garlic there. My wife got on her hands and knees and pulled out all the grass that was in there, man. I'm telling you. Talk about hard work. Getting on your knees and doing that. That took her most of the day yesterday, if not all day. All right, see, it won't focus. Keeps unfocusing. Yeah, here's the garlic. It'll be coming up in about another 3 to 4 weeks. We put down in November last year, first week of November, first 4 or 5 days. So it should have, bulbs about size of about 1.5, no, about 2 sizes of 2 golf balls together. So they should be good sized bulbs, not like you get in the store. Well, although you do get them in the store, but they're Monsanto. They're genetically modified so that they're bigger. They're not healthier, trust me. If it's genetically modified, folks, it's not healthy. That's why Europe won't buy our crap. American people eat it all the time because it's, it's good for you. It's not. I say it a lot and people get sick of hearing it, but I don't give a shit either. We cornered the market on stupid, folks. And if you argue with that, well then, you just proved my point. So, that's the garden out here. Got okra, zucchini, garlic, peas, beans and peas. Tomatoes, cucumbers and cantaloupe and honeydews and watermelon in that back corner. And by the house we got lettuce, cool mint crisp lettuce. And for the idiot people, it doesn't taste like mint. It's the name of it. That's a heirloom lettuce. It almost looks like a dandelion leaf, but it, I'm not even going all the way back over there to show it. But, okay, I say another week we should have tomatoes out there. I'm surprised we don't have any on there yet. I haven't really looked good. It's hard to do it while I'm holding this camera, but, those tomatoes got a lot of flowers on them, so I would think by this week, coming up by Saturday, Sunday, we should have a bunch of tomatoes on there. And when they come, they'll start coming out within about a week. They'll be ready to be picked, so... We got a giant sunflower growing up right there. Got a torch sunflower growing right there with the orange flowers for the big wing butterflies, monarch butterflies, and honeybees. That's a mammoth sunflower right there. I think all of these around the garden here are either mammoth or titan sunflowers, which are heirloom seeds sunflowers. So by the house, we transplanted a few that were right up on the garden. I wanted them because I thought they were... Torch was bush out and one of them by the house. I think, but to look at them, I'm thinking it's more of a yellow type. there. While I'm right here, so I'm gonna go over. This is just a small example. Out back is where we have a bunch of this lettuce. This is just a little bit my wife transplanted out over here, because I just put a bag of potting soil down here, so it's not a lot to begin with. Got biting flies out here, but that's the lettuce. It's called Cool Crisp Mint. It's an heirloom lettuce. Right in there, there's a couple sporadic right in there, and we got some over there. We thought they would look like tomatoes over here. So we planted two tomatoes for sure, where the darker soil is, that's for the potting soil. That one inside the cage there was growing, and I put a tomato stick there, and then I put that cage around it. We didn't plant tomatoes over here, but that looks like a tomato plant to me. I'm pretty sure it is, too. And then my wife planted one yesterday, or 2 days ago there, and that one down there where the dark soil is at. Those are tomatoes. They got to be watered later. See, the sun's on here for a few hours. Got biting flies out here too, and when the sun goes off of here around 1 o'clock or so, might pour water around the base, not on the plant, but just around the base. These flies, sorry, but that's the lettuce I was talking about around back. We got plastic down, and we got a bunch of it. It's all crowded together, unfortunately, but we got a bunch of lettuce back there. Had BLTs for the last 2 days, so the only thing is about the damn tomato and bacon, which I hate. Getting to the point where I hate bacon too because of all the crap that's in that. But the lettuce was from out here, not here, but from out back. And the tomatoes were from store-bought, but I think it's Aldi's where you get better quality of vegetable than you do most places, Aldi's. So anyway, that's it. That's the garden for 2018 so far. First week of June. Right, technically the 11th, but still first week of June. Oh, yeah, I use an electric trimmer because I'm not keen on those gas ones myself. Bad knees, bad health, overweight, but I'm trying to do the best. My wife's cutting the grass right now on one side of the yard, and she did the front yard, and I focus the front yard. I'll do this yard and around the garden with the power assist mower. Just do a little at a time. It's supposed to get hot today, and then tomorrow it's going to be in the 90s. Actually, all week up until like Saturday next week, 88, 89, 90 roughly. So say 90. And it's a 30 to 40% chance of rain every day also. So she did all that by herself. We got about 13 or 14 bags of red mulch over there. So went out and bought some of that screening to go underneath it and went around the tree and then put that mulch around it. So anyway, all I can tell you need to grow some food, folks. I mean, President Trump doing what he can, but you know what? We got more communists and socialists in this country fighting against us, so I'm hoping we'll have enough food for us and a few people if they need it. But you need to be growing some kind of food. And I mean, scoff, the stupid people are the ones that all laugh about it. So the ones that kind of roll their eyes or just say whatever kind of stupid comment kind of proves my point about cornering the market on stupid in this country. So, but I'm telling you, that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to get ourselves our own vegetables, beans, tomatoes, watermelon, cantaloupe, zucchini, okra, garlic, lettuce, and sunflowers. That stuff out there in the field, I wouldn't eat that stuff if you had a gun to my head, because it's not food, folks. It's not food. The corn you buy in the supermarket is not food. It's a food-like, L-I-K-E, product. Monsanto is doing this, and that's why countries in Europe will not import our food. It's nothing to do with tariffs, and it's because it's genetically modified, and you... I can't say it enough. The idiots in this country don't see it. They don't want to see it. I guess they figure that it's so bad that they're better off just to go along. So when they start fucking... Well, I'm sorry. I can't help it. I get very upset because it's stupid in this country. I hate stupid. So You gotta look in the mirror and decide yourself. That's the person that's either doing or holding yourself back. If you got any kind of space where you can make a small garden, even one of these small gardens, if you could put a row of tomatoes, row of peppers, and so forth, you know, that would be a good thing compared to what you're doing now. But as long as you keep going to the store and just buying that shit, which is what it is, you ain't got no room to say a damn thing about anything. Roll over and die. I wish you would do it faster than later, so. All right, folks. I hope you have a prosperous life. Helping people rather than putting people down. Negative repels and positive attracts. So, please, do something that's positive. Something that makes it better for you and those around you. Heirloom Solutions is a good place, I suggest. And Starks with Starksbrothers.com. Got elderberry bushes back there, trees. They call them trees, but they're like bushes right now. Inside, a couple chicken wire loops like those beans are right here. These flies. I'm sorry if the camera keeps going on because I'm trying to swat these flies off my ankles. But there you go. All right. I don't know how long this is, but hopefully you'll watch it to the end. You need to try to grow something, folks. I mean, if you can get a small piece of, you know, get 5-gallon buckets. A couple of friends of mine are using buckets. Some people, my brother's using planters, the big, big planters you see for like $20 at China Mart or Kmart. Well, Kmart, I don't think is almost in existence anymore. China Mart's taking over. Kind of suspicious about that, huh? No, it's right. It's just the way it's supposed to be. But, Get like 4 or 5 5-gallon buckets and get about, if you can get 10 bags of potting soil, not potting mix, not, you can get that if you want, but potting soil is your best bet. Get some proto-grow liquid fertilizer, 9 teaspoons to a gallon of water. It's fish emollients and seaweed mix, and it smells, I'll tell you that. But look at what it's doing for our vegetables. You can spray it on them, not in the sun. You shouldn't spray them in the sun because it's just the heat is not good for them. But you can spray it on the leaves and pour it into the base, and it promotes healthy vegetables. So I need to do more for those tomatoes this evening or tomorrow morning, depending on if it's going to rain. And if it rains, it's fine because it's liquid anyway. It goes into the ground. Get 2 points from this. Monsanto sucks. It's not real food. And heirloom vegetables is better, and you need to do it yourself. And you'll have more pride, and you know you'll do a better job because it's for your health. That's all. I'm gonna zoom in on the flowers on the zucchini and then I'm gonna shut it off. Focus. There it is.